guys, good morning. Welcome to Harsha's Thoughts. Hope you're all doing good. Today I'm going to discuss a math problem. So do you all know what is 1 plus 2? Well, 1 plus 2 equals to 3. Do you know what is 1 plus 2 plus 3? Yes, we can still manage it. We calculated 1 plus 2, 3. 3 plus 3 equals to 6. Do you know what is 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4? We still can manage it. 1 plus 2 plus 3 equals to 6. 6 plus 4 equals to 10. But do you know what is 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus so on plus 20? Well, we can give a try, but it's a bit hard to calculate. Do you know what is 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus so on plus 190? Well, this is hard to calculate. So, we have a formula. As I told you, we can calculate the sum of larger numbers. So, I have a formula n into n plus 1 by 2. So, let us take an example. 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus so on plus 200. So this is very hard to calculate. So using this method, we can easily find the answer for this problem. So here, n is the number of digits. In this example, the last digit is 200. So 200 into 200 plus 1, 201. 200 into 201 by 2. So, simply 200 by 2, 100 into 201. So, simply 201 into 1, 201 and add 2 zeros. So, this is the sum of the numbers up till 200. So 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 200 is equals to 20,100. So using this formula, we can add up till any number. So let me discuss a word problem where we can apply the formula. Here is the problem. Two guests shake hands exactly once with one another. How many handshakes are exchanged among 9 guests? So, here are the 9 people. The first person gave the remaining 8 1 shake hand. So, the first person gave 8 shake hands. The second person gave 7 shake hands, as the first person already gave a shake hand. So, 8 plus 7. And so on, the third person 6, fourth one 5, fifth one 4, 6 1 3, 7 1 2, and the 8th person 1. So here we can apply the formula n into n plus 1 by 2. So here the last digit is 8. The greatest digit is 8. So 8 into 8 plus 1, which equals to 9 by 2. So 8 divided by 2, 4. 4 into 9, which equals to 36. So 36 handshakes are exchanged among 9 guests. So we can use this formula in complex problems also. I just used this formula in a simple problem to explain you guys more clearly. Hope you like this video. If you did, please subscribe and give a huge thumbs up. Thanks for watching. Bye.